Maastricht is an old city that goes back to before the Roman Empire, and old remainings are still here. You see here an old picture of Maastricht, and you see here a very old bridge, and in fact, this is the old Roman bridge that was there. And if you look where we are now, this bridge is still there, and this is the old city. And there are quite some historical sites there. And if you see this, you say, wow, is this the place where we're going to have the next meeting? And I can tell you, well, we decided not to have the meeting in this place. and there is a good reason for this. Maastricht has the highest bars and restaurants density of Europe, with close to a little bit more than 100,000 inhabitants. The number of bars and restaurants exceeds 400. So if you have a conference there, you run the risk that everybody is out instead of in a meeting. So what we decided to do is go to a place that is closer there, but is very historical. This is our research center. You see the academic medical center. In the bottom, you see the university building there, and it is linked to Nutrim, that is the nutrition and toxicology research group. And this is the room of Alan Black. And my room is just three windows away from that. So that's where we are. But where do we go to? And we decided to go to a place where if we have you there, that we have you there, and you can't go out, you know? We take you to an old monastery abbey, and you know, as the people that live there, you will get dry whole grain bread, you will get lots of beer and lots of wine, and you have to do a lot of thinking and a prayer in the morning and in the evening, and then we'll have a fantastic meeting for 3 days in a row. So that's where we take you, and this is the old abbey. It is a fantastic place. It is outside in the fields. There is no disco or whatever around. But I can assure you there will be lots of fun because I love parties and Alan likes to dance too. A few pictures of where we are. This is the front side. This is the central core side. So we are going to have the meeting there. We made up an organizing committee. Alan is in the lead. I'm in there, Susan Bowser, Tanja Adam, Luc van Loon, Mireille Serlie, Gijs Goos, and Simone Eus, and Edith Veskens. And we got Ulf, who is on the board of the NSG, in the meetings until now. And we will extend this with a scientific advisory board to go on. And we already defined the preliminary main topics that you see here. Food quantity and quality in type 2 diabetes, proteins quantity and quality in type 2 diabetes, related to that also sarcopenia is a big issue, food quantity and quality, atopic fat, insulin sensitivity, better cell function, carbohydrate staple foods and metabolic flexibility. Then nutrition, insulin resistance and the brain is a new topic for the conference, but a lot is going on in the brain. Gut microbes and diabetes part has been discussed here, and we want to extend on that. Is when we eat as important as what we eat? And this is a key question because there are so many diets where they say you should not eat in the evening, or you should this, or you should first eat the carbohydrate and then that. Global dietary guidelines for diabetes, and we'll try to line up with the developing work within the NSG, then the pros and cons of carbohydrate restriction. There is continuing debate on that area, and there will be more data by then. And then finally, personalized subgroup-based nutrition, just one size fits all. So these are selected themes. We are trying to build around it, and meanwhile, we have established a list of potential keynote speakers that we'll further discuss with some of our scientific advisors in the board, and we will disseminate that in not too long time. We'll contact these keynotes, because with a year to go, we want to be sure that they are available. Now, if you look to the abbey, I said, well, dried whole grain and wine and beer, they have their own beer, you know, that's nice to have. Eh? But this is an economy room here. Economy room for two people, then you have a shower, a shared shower with three other rooms, but it's a very nice room. And look at this, this is a comfort room, and it's in the old abbey, and the rooms are perfect, and I can tell you the prices are fantastic. You will find out if you come out with the prices for the conference. What took me was when I was taken down in the cellars. You know, this is the cellar for the evening that you see here on the bottom line, where they have lots of wine and beer. And if we are there with this conference, we are the only big group that is there. So, you know, we will have fun. This is a part of the restaurant, the brasserie. It's a great, really great place to be. And for those who are interested, we can make an appointment to go into the ancient library. This goes back to the 1600, around 1600. It's most fantastic library, but you can have a look in there. Now, one thing, how do we get there? Well, we have a number of airports in the near surrounding. Maastricht is very close, only 25 kilometers, and there are cheap flights going to Maastricht from certain areas in Europe. So you have to look into that. And Cologne Airport is 100 kilometers, Brussels is 130, Eindhoven 110, Amsterdam is 230, but there is there is a very good intercity going close to Rolduc, and Dusseldorf is 90 kilometers. So there's plenty of opportunities to come there. We set some timelines because we want to be very well in time, get the abstracts settled, etc. Our aim is to start the registration for the conference and also for the hotel rooms by December 1. We will open the opportunity to come in as an early bird by then. The abstract submission we want to open by January 1, and we want to have the abstract acceptance confirmation by April 1. So we'll have to do the work then in the first quarter. And anyone who has submitted an abstract will have an idea about oral presentation or abstract or poster presentation by April 1. Invited speaker contacts, as I said, we already made a list, and in summer, autumn, we will work on this to get this finalized. And that should lead to a full program outline on the website by January 1. So the whole frame of the program should be there with all the key topics, the keynote speakers, etc. And since we know the acceptance by April 1, we will have the final program, including all the slots for short oral communications by April 1. And that should give sufficient time for anyone to come in. The website is online since this week. So you can find it if you type DNSG 2019, automatically you find this website. It is Mint Online. It says Mint Online is linked to the program Eatwell. And Eatwell is a program of our university medical center together with the university, and they have lots of nutrition. The website we put in there, and you see here the venue accommodation, registration, abstracts, programs, sponsors, welcome, and here it says under construction because part of these things we need to fill in. But this is where we are now, and what I would like to say is reserve the dates, June 12 to 15. We will start on June the 12th. In the afternoon, after lunchtime, and we'll finish the 15th in the late evening with a dinner party. And just as we are going to have big fun tonight, we will have there as well. And then people can fly back on Saturday morning, subsequent to that. So make a notice. If anyone has any idea about important things or contents or whatever, contact Alan or me. You will find our contact addresses and the emails on the website you've seen here. And we'll hope to make an excellent meeting. Okay? And Ellen and I are here, but we... We have a good team of people around us, and we line up with the DNSG board. We will have lots of interaction, and I think we'll move forward smoothly. Thank you very much.